Did you always have your name? Has it come from outside? So you cannot be your name. The first two cells of your body came from your parents, right? Everything else is food, water, air, sun, coming from the outside. So can you be your body? Even this you have acquired from somewhere, right? Can you be your religion? Did you always have a religion, or did it come from an outside source? Who gave it to you? Society, nation, did you always have them, or have they come from outside? So the first step is seeing what all has come from outside and not to identify too closely with it. Seeing that all this is coming from outside. More importantly, all of us hold so many beliefs, right? All of us hold so many beliefs in our mind. Beliefs like, why must I do engineering? All of us have a particular belief about it. What is the meaning of career? What is the meaning of money? What is the meaning of education, love, truth, freedom? Now, where are all these concepts, all these beliefs coming from? They are not a result of our own investigation. They are coming from outside. So I cannot be what I believe to be, because all these beliefs have been put into our mind from somebody else, from an external source or many sources, correct? So all the contents of my mind, they are also external. I cannot be that. When I ask who am I cannot be the contents of my mind, which means that I cannot be my thoughts. I cannot be this body, because every bit of it is coming from outside. Even the entire movement, I can decide. Do you decide the rate at which your heart would beat? How many of you decide? Do you decide the rate at which you would inhale and exhale air? Do you decide? All of this system, all of this regulation is also coming from outside. You didn't decide. Do you decide the color of your hair and the color of your eyes? Do you decide that you are going to have five fingers in your palm hand? You don't decide, right? So no need to identify too closely with all this. However, when you are understanding all this, surely there is somebody who is seeing, who is understanding that I am not this, not that. Surely you have a capacity to understand. Did this capacity also come from outside? You see, there is this camera. This is a very advanced machine. Man has given it the capacity to receive these audio waves, these light waves, and record them, right? So all its design has come from outside. Its purpose has come from outside, and its master is also outside. But this camera, in spite of receiving the same light waves and sound waves that you are receiving, can never understand what you are understanding. You are looking at me, this camera is also looking at me. You are hearing me, this camera is also hearing me out. But this will never, never, never understand what I say. Forget about this camera. Even the most advanced machine that any human being can ever make in the future will never be able to understand what I am saying. That means this capacity to understand cannot be given. Could it be given, we would have given it to this camera. Are you getting it? Everything else comes from outside. The capacity to understand does not come from outside. That is entirely yours. In fact, that is the only thing that is yours. Are you getting it? Everything else that is there in your life comes from outside, except your capacity to understand. That is entirely yours. That nobody can give to you and nobody can take away from you. Your intelligence, your capacity to understand. If somebody would give it to you, it could also be given to a machine. If not today, then sometimes in future. But no machine can ever be given the capacity to understand. It can be given the capacity to record or to analyze, but analysis is not understanding. No machine will ever understand. That capacity to understand is you. That intelligence is you. Are you getting it? Everything else is external. All else is external. That is not external. What is not external? That intelligence. That ability to understand. That is what makes you a human being. Your religion does not make you a human being. Your gender does not make you a human being. Your body does not make you a human being. Your intelligence makes you a human being. And if you do not have that ability to understand, you are not a human being. Please do not think that merely being born as a human qualifies you to call yourself human. No, you are not human till the time your intelligence is not awakened. Even at this moment, those who are understanding, they are human beings. And those who are not understanding, they are not fit to be called human beings. Getting it? Yes? Alright. Thank you.